Before we dive into today's content, a quick shout out to our sponsor, NextPCB. More about them later in the video. To perform an ERC check on any circuit, follow these steps. First, annotate the schematic. To do that, click on Annotate Schematic. Now, click on Annotate, and then save the schematic. Next, click on the Electrical Rules Checker button. In the pop-up window, click on Run ERC. As you can see, we have 2 errors and 103 warnings. Let's resolve them one by one. Start by enabling the Errors option to view the errors. Here we see the error, Input Power Pin not driven by any output power pins. This is a common error we get in KiCad. This is the location of the first error, and this is the location of the second error. To fix this, click on the Place Power Symbol button. Next, search for power flag. Now, place it near the ground. Now, if we run the ERC check, the first error should be resolved. Do the same for the second error. Here, I have placed the power flag on the input line to fix the second error. After running the ERC check again, all errors should now be resolved. Next, let's address the warnings. Enable the warnings option to view them. The first warning is, symbol pin or wire end off connection grid. To fix this, first select the entire schematic. Then, right-click on any component or wire. Click on Align Items to Grid. Run the ERC check again to see if the warning is resolved. If it's not resolved, right-click on Show Grid and then click on Edit Grid. Now set the grid to 1.27 mm under the grid column. Also, make sure Grid 1, Connected Items, Wires, and Text are all set to 1.27 mm. Once again, select the entire schematic. Right-click on any component or wire. Click on Align Items to Grid. Now, run the ERC check again. The next warning says, both input and output 2 are attached to the same item. Input will be used in the netlist. This happened because the input line has 2 different labels, input and output 2. To fix this, remove the output 2 label from the input line. Next, change the output 2 at the transformer to input. Finally, run the ERC check once more to confirm the warning is resolved. If you get the pin not connected error, it means you either forgot to connect the pin, or you did not add the no connection flag to that pin. In this circuit, pin 4 is not connected because it's a no connection pin. To fix this error, click on Place No Connect Flag button, and place it on pin 4 of the IC. Now run the ERC check to confirm the error has been resolved. Next, let's resolve the warnings in this circuit. To do that, enable warnings to view them. If you get the warning, the current configuration does not include the symbol library. It means this IC is not linked to any library in KiCad. In this case, the UM3561 was created by me, and I forgot to add its path to the library. To fix this, click on Preferences. Then click on Manage Symbol Libraries. Scroll to the bottom and click on the Add button. Next, select the library path of your symbol. Give your symbol library a name and then click OK. Now run the ERC check again to see if the warning has been resolved. Next, let's look at the warning. Symbol doesn't match copy in the library. This usually happens when upgrading from one KiCad version to another. To fix it, simply delete the component and then add it again. After adding, don't forget to annotate the schematic. Now run the ERC check to confirm the warning has been resolved. If you get the duplicate items error, it means you may have components with same name, or the circuit was not annotated properly. To fix this, just re-annotate the schematic as shown earlier in the video. Now run the ERC check to confirm the error has been resolved. The pin connected error has already been explained in the previous section. Now, let's look at ignored tests. In the ERC checker pop-up window, go to the Ignored Test tab. Here you'll see all the tests that were skipped. If you want to enable any of these skipped tests, go to File. Then click on Schematic Setup. In the Schematic Setup pop-up window, click on Electrical Rules. On the left, you will see the list of all tests. Select any ignore test and change it to either error or warning. For example, let's change global label only appears once in the schematic from ignore to warning. Now, when you perform the ERC check, it will also check for warnings related to global labels appearing only once in the schematic. Next, let's see how to perform DRC checks. To perform a DRC check, open the PCB editor with your PCB design. Now, click on the Design Rules Checker button. Then, click on Run DRC. As you can see, we have 2 errors and 11 warnings. Let's resolve them one by one. First, enable the Errors option to view them. Here we have the error, hole size out of range. To fix this, double-click on the via hole. Now, change the diameter and hole size to the minimum required values, which is 0.3 mm and 0.5 mm. And then click OK. Run the DRC check again to confirm the error is resolved. Next, let's resolve the warnings. Enable the Warnings option to view them. The first warning is text height out of range. To fix this, double-click on the text and set the width and height to the minimum size, which is 0.8 mm. Run the DRC check again to confirm. Repeat this process for all text height out of range warnings, then run the DRC check. If you encounter a silkscreen overlap warning, this means one text is overlapping with another. To fix it, simply move the overlapping text. Then, run the DRC check to verify the warning is cleared. In the DRC checker pop-up window, go to the Ignore Test tab. Here, you'll see all the tests that were skipped. If you want to enable any of these skipped tests, go to File and then click on Board Setup. In the Board Setup pop-up, click on Violation Severity under Design Rules. On the left, you'll see a list of all tests. Now, select any ignore test and change it to either an error or a warning. For example, let's change Footprint has no courtyard defined from ignore to warning. Now, when you perform a DRC check, it will check for that warning as well. Next, let's solve the warning. Footprint does not match copy in library. This usually happens when updating KiCad from one version to another. To fix it, right-click on the component. Click on Update Footprint. In the pop-up window, click on Update. Now, run the DRC check again to verify the warning is resolved. Repeat this for all footprint does not match copy in library warnings and perform the DRC check. To import the DRC template of any manufacturer, follow these steps. First, download the template from the manufacturer's website. For me, that's NextPCB, who is also the sponsor of this video. They offer a wide range of PCB services such as PCB prototyping, assembly, flex PCBs, and more. If you're a new user, you can also get a discount. So, check them out at nextpcb.com. To download NextPCB's DRC template, go to this link. Scroll down until you find Download on GitHub. Click on it, and it will take you to the GitHub page. Now, download the template folder and extract the files. Next, open the PCB editor in KiCad. Click on File, then go to Board Setup. Now, click on Import Settings from another board and select the file. Next, click on Select All and then click Import Settings. After that, perform the DRC check to see if there are any errors. It's always better to import the manufacturer's DRC template before you start designing your PCB. This way, you can avoid unnecessary mistakes. Here, I have a text thickness error. To solve this, click on the text with the error and change the thickness to the minimum value, which is 0.125 mm. Once you've made the change, click on Run DRC to check if the warning is resolved. Now do this for all the same warnings. That's it for this video. If you have any doubts or need help with an error, feel free to leave a comment. I'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching. And please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel.